most companies understand the importance of an employee code of conduct, which is a formal document that communicates how employees should act at work. An employee code of conduct sets the standard for acceptable and unacceptable behavior. It's a set of guiding values, norms, policies, and expectations. When executed well, a code of conduct can promote ethical behavior and curb misconduct. It can reinforce company values, and in some situations, it can even provide legal grounds for a misbehaving employee's termination. The advantages of an employee code of conduct are clear, but what to include in one isn't always so obvious. So, what should you include in your code of conduct, and how can you make sure that it's effective? First, let's talk about the format and contents of an employee code of conduct. Employee codes of conduct are company-specific, which means they differ from organization to organization. However, most codes of conduct follow a similar structure and contain similar content. Here's a basic outline to use as a starting point. First, start with an eye-catching title page and an easy-to-navigate table of contents. Second, communicate the objectives of the code of conduct, followed by a letter from leadership that endorses it. Third, state the company's mission and list its values. You might also choose to include a description of the company culture you're hoping to create. To recap so far, you've started with a title page and a table of contents. You've established objectives and provided a letter from leadership. And you've outlined the company's mission, values, and culture. All these elements are the introduction to or setup for your code of conduct. They provide context before getting into the real meat and potatoes of the document, which is up next. Now you're ready to introduce the core standards and expectations. This is what the document is really about. It's where you cover the core expectations and provisions for employee conduct. For example, you might cover topics like harassment and discrimination, corruption and conflicts of interest, professional integrity, employment practices, and more. After the core standards and expectations, consider adding a section that explains your process for reporting, investigating, and disciplining code of conduct violations. Encourage employees to speak up when they witness or suspect unethical behavior, and tell managers how they should respond to reports. Finally, the last section of your code of conduct is the conclusion and additional contact information. Summarize a few key takeaways from the code of conduct, and make it easy for employees to find who to contact for reporting violations or asking questions. Use this outline as a general framework. It will be easier to fill in the details if you involve others in the discussion. In other words, ask leaders and employees from different departments what they think is important. Not only will involving others help to obtain their buy-in, but it will also ensure that you don't overlook anything important. You can also follow these three tips to make your code of conduct more engaging and useful for employees. The first tip is to write as you speak. Use plain language that's easy to read and understand. Avoid jargon and overcomplicated legalese when you can. Employees must be able to understand the code of conduct to practice it. Second, make your code of conduct visually appealing. Break text into digestible sections with headings. Add images, illustrations, or graphics. Use color, bolding, or other forms of text emphasis to draw the reader's attention. Do whatever you can to make your code of conduct visually interesting and enjoyable. That way, employees are more likely to pay attention and read it through to the end. Finally, the last tip is to keep your code of conduct as simple and concise as possible. Use short sentences. Avoid lengthy words or run-on sentences. And remember, less is often more. It's not possible to cover every ethical dilemma employees might face. Instead, think of your code of conduct as a framework for ethical behavior and decision-making. Creating a strong and ethical work culture starts with establishing shared norms, values, and behavioral expectations. That's the power of an employee code of conduct. The best codes of conduct aren't a dry list of rules and legalese. Instead, they're a declaration of who your company is and what you stand for. Follow these tips to develop a code of conduct that's effective engaging, and truly reflective of your company's values, beliefs, and culture.